thank you all for coming here today. As a courtesy, please make sure your cell phone is silent. We don't want to disturb the lovely day. Also, marriage. Together we are gathered here to witness a truly special ceremony, the union of Victor and Jennifer in marriage and in the presence of those family and friends nearest and dearest to them. You all can sit down back. Victor and Jennifer, today we celebrate the power of your love and the strength of your eternal bond. Before we begin, take a moment to look around at the many friendly faces surrounding you today. Know that we are all here to offer love, support, and encouragement as you embark on this amazing journey together. There are few greater joys in this life than finding someone with whom we truly identify, someone to whom we can bear our hearts and souls, someone for whom we will gladly give all our time, our energy, and our future. And in that spirit, I will now share a short reading from author Charlotte Bronte. I have, for the first time, found what I can truly love. I have found you. You are my sympathy, my better self, my good angel. I am bound to you with a strong attachment. I think you good, gifted, lovely. A fervent, solemn passion is conceived in my heart. It leans to you, draws you to my center and spring of life, wraps my existence about you, and kindly, in pure, powerful plane, fuses me and you into one. My wish for both you today is that this ceremony will provide you with wonderful memories to look back on to treasure for years to come. Jennifer and Victor, as you stand here today before your family and friends, I realize that you're preparing to celebrate one of life's greatest gifts, the depths of which you have only begun to explore. Your level of love and commitment is something that many seek, and yet not everyone finds. The bond you share is rare in this world, and its fruits more valuable than any precious stone or metal. Marriage, of course, is more than a formal exchange of rings. It is a sacred and solemn promise to one another that no matter what, you're in this together. Life is full of surprises, both positive and negative. By nature, it's impossible to know what is around the next bend. However, with a trusted partner by your side, you may take comfort in the unknown. Whatever storms may come, you will weather them together. That is the beauty of love. Not only does it cradle us when we are feeling weak and tired, it creates a solid foundation on which we can always rely. Henceforth, your lives will become permanently entwined. The union you form here today is built to withstand any and all challenges. Through sorrow and joy, proof of success and failure, for despair and triumph, your bond will persevere, bolstered by the everlasting love that you share. With the vows you exchange today, you will both finalize this promise and begin life anew together. As we gather here today, let us also recognize the seriousness of this occasion. Marriage is profound, sincere commitment, and one worthy of our reverence. Love is the soil from which life grows itself. As Carl Sagan famously wrote, the world is so exquisite, with so much love and moral depth, we should remain grateful every day for the brief but magnificent opportunity that life provides. The sum of all our evolution, our thinking, and our accomplishments is love. I will now invite the bride and groom to exchange vows that they have prepared for one another. Victor and Jennifer, would you like to share those vows now with us? Jennifer, would you like to go first?
First, I want to say that I feel so lucky and so happy to be standing up here with you today. That being said, I want to promise to love you for all your wonderful weirdness, your genuine kindness, and your wild creativity. I promise to support you in your dreams, even the one about the dancing ape and the talking parrot. I promise to try really, really hard not to suppress your inner bard, no matter how embarrassing or poorly timed it may be. I promise not to keep score, even though I'm totally winning. I promise to keep track of your keys and your sunglasses and your headphones,
and your flippy floppies and your cell phone and any other belongings that you so frequently misplace. I promise to wait as patiently as I can to watch the next episode of whatever show we have been binging together. I promise I will not watch ahead. I promise to laugh at all your clever puns and all your Monty Python references. I promise to always look on the bright side of life. But most of all, I promise to grow old with you until we are worn and gray, until we sit holding wrinkled hands, shaking our opposing wrinkled fists, and screaming at those darn kids to get off our lawn.
Waiting to watch a show, it's pretty good commitment there. Victor, would you like to?
Yes. Jeni, my love, I never knew how hard it was to write vows until I started trying. Because I may get distracted by a meme or a kitten or a Thug Life video. I'm far from perfect, but what I can promise is that I will always love you and the children and will be a very good husband and stepfather as long as we shall live. Amen. Hallelujah. Mazel tov.
I feel your pain on the scene, fam, but that is true commitment. Victor and Jennifer, will you now join hands? Victor, do you take Jennifer as your wife and your lifelong companion? Do you promise to share her laughter during the good times and wipe her tears away during the bad from this day forward? Jennifer, do you take Victor as your husband and lifelong companion? Do you promise to share in his laughter during the good times and wipe his tears away during the bad from this day forward? Let us proceed.
Mama.
Having spoken the official words, now it is time for the fasting of your hands that will seal your union on a spiritual level. This ritual is one of deep significance. Please interlace your hands together, taking care to breathe slowly and focus on the connection being created with each other and the surrounding universe. Jennifer, Victor, I'm going to ask you to now look deep into each other's eyes and remember all that you have experienced together, both the highs and the lows, and where that has brought you here today as you fully commit to one another. As I ask the bride and groom to reflect, I also invite everyone to reflect on the journey that brought Jennifer and Victor together. All of us have been asked by these two lovely people to witness their union. I imagine we can all appreciate this journey that these two are about to partake together. And now, after a moment of reflection among your family and friends, you will be united in partnership, ready to support one another through both the joys and the sorrows of life. It is now time to fasten your hands together, a tradition that has spanned generations. This act symbolizes a deep commitment to your shared union. As your hands are bound before us today, so will your lives become. While this ribbon will soon be unwrapped, your spirit will forever be joined in unity from this moment forward. Let us acknowledge the special bond you share, and may your relationship would be blessed with joy and happiness. Now for the exchange of rings. Wedding ring is a symbol of the unending power of love between two beings. Its circular shape has no beginning and no end, representing a boundless spiritual connection. The ring should be worn as a symbol of commitment between one another. Even when as you find yourselves apart, your rings will provide a powerful reminder of the eternal love you share. Now, Victor, please repeat after me. With this ring, I, Victor, commit my love and life to you, giving you all that I am and all that I will be. Please accept this ring as a symbol of my undying love. Jennifer, will you please repeat after me? With this ring, I, Jennifer, commit my love and life to you, giving you all that I am and all that I will be. Please accept this ring as a symbol of my undying love. Victor and Jennifer, today you've made sacred vows and you've exchanged your rings. You have given yourselves fully to each other until the end of your days. Thus, it seems only fitting that the first gift of your new life should be an hourglass. For centuries, the hourglass has been considered an enduring symbol of the passage of time, so it is only appropriate that this gift will represent the beginning of your new lives as husband and wife. In every part of life, there are challenges. As we all reflected before on your journey here today, marriage will be no different. It might be difficult at times to find the words to express your feelings for one another. If this should happen, simply regard this memento and remember the very moment in time when you first filled it together, committing yourselves in a lifetime of memories to one another. As you think back and remember this marriage ceremony specifically, remember that it was love that brought you here today, and that it is only with love that a marriage may endure throughout the passage of time.
songs I realize just what you
beloved family and friends, by the power vested in me by the Universal Life Church and by the state of Iowa, I now formally pronounce Victor and Jennifer to be husband and wife. Victor, you may now catch your bride. Jennifer, may you enjoy a lifetime of sunrises and sunsets together. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to present, for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Victor and Jennifer Kramer Luckey-Gunn Wilson.
Yeah, I'm sure you're gonna go on so many epic adventures. I love you guys. So, let the adventures begin. Cheers to the bride and groom.
I don't really have anything prepared. I just wanted to thank everybody that came from near and far, and we're so happy to see you all. And let's party! Woo!
Count on it.